Today we are going to deal with the topic of stress. Let us start with the meaning and definition of stress. Stress is defined as a pattern of negative physiological states and psychological responses occurring in situations where people perceive threats to their well-being, which they may be unable to meet. So in this definition, you can see here, stress, how can we identify the stress? So it is identified with the negative physiological states. The negative physiological responses of our body signifies the stress, and the psychological responses occurring in that particular situation. The fear, the anxiety, the feeling of not doing something required in that situation. So all these things comes under the stress, the high level of arousal. So there are many things which comes under the psychological responses of our stress, and the individual is not ready to meet those physical and the psychological responses and the situation which is occurring there. So this whole phenomena is known as the stress. Another definition is by the Jarvis in 1999. Here he says that the stress is the process whereby an individual perceives a threat and responds with a series of psychological and physiological changes, including increased arousal and the experience of anxiety. So in this definition, it is clearly stated that the anxiety and the arousal will be increased during the situation in the stress, and the rest of the things are similar as in the first definition, like physical and the psychological changes and the responses which we have talked about. Stress, it is a process which begins with a demand. It includes our experience of thinking about that demand. Whether we are thinking in a positive direction or in a negative direction during the demand conditions. And it ends with a stress response that would be our psychological, example anxiety, or behavioral responses along with the physiological responses. Types of stress. There are mainly two types of stress which an athlete faces. These are the distress and the eustress. Distress is the stress related with the negative approach, which considerate the too much work or too much pressure on the athlete. And eustress is the kind of positive stress in which the performance of an athlete increases. Let us see it in a detailed manner. Eustress is a good stress. It can positively affect your performance, and athletes often aim for this psychological state and it can enhance their performance. Distress is a bad stress, as I already said, and it is most common form of stress. Actually, we consider stress in the form of distress only. When the good stress is going on in our life, we do not consider that it is a kind of stress. So distress is shows the negative impact on an athlete's performance. It deteriorates the performance of the athlete, and in terms of definition of the stress, it is brought upon by a perceived inability to meet the demand in a sports. When we define the distress in sports, it is said that it is the inability of an individual to meet the demands required for the sports condition. The positive and the negative stress that we have studied, there is the impact or the effect at the four levels in our body, that is physical, mental, emotional and spiritual levels. The stress, when we say physical impact creates on the body, that would be the symptom showed by the fever or shivering of the body or by sweating. So these are some symptoms shown when we have the physical stress. Then mental stress will be on the brain itself. We will be thinking, we will be deciding, discriminating something, we will be acting in our mind about something. So when a deep thought creates in our mind, that is the result of the mental stress. And spiritual and emotional stress is the last one here. Emotional stress is related to your feelings, emotions, intuitions. So in emotional stress, there comes when you think about the negative aspects of something, when you imagine about the negative outcomes of something. So that will be your emotional kind of stress, where your feelings and emotions are associated. When you feel bad about something happens in that particular way. So that is the emotional stress on our body. So then last is the spiritual stress. In this, the identity, perception, values, self-awareness, self-respect are the key factors. So in this, the individual when faces problems with the identity, problems with the right perceptions, problems with the values and ethics in the life, and he is having the problem with the self-awareness and self-respect kind of problems. So spiritual stress is associated with the high level of stress. The stress impact you can see here with the diagram. In this, eustress and distress has been clearly indicated. It is the performance graph you can see here. The performance in the eustress condition increases. The health of the individual will be good. And in eustress, you can see the individual attains the peak performance. After that, when the distress comes in the mind or distress comes in the situation, then there will be the degeneration of your performance. The health will be slowly degenerating and the performance will be slowly coming down. You will feel fatigue, you will feel very much anxious, you will feel very much disappointed. So these kind of things will be the distress. Here you can see the performance after the performance parameters. Here are also health, attention, feeling and the states given. So when we are under the eustress condition, our attention will be effortless. The feelings will be of challenge. You will feel challenge in doing particular thing. You will enjoy the process while in eustress. And the state will be you will be in the flowing state. The everything will be going very smoothly. You will be flowing in the direction. So you will be having a very good state of mind at the eustress. In the distress, you can see here the attention will be scattered. You will be focusing on the different aspects of after the performance. So you will be having your attention on the outcome rather than the process. So you will be very tensed at this particular time. The feeling will be either of the bored feeling after completing the particular task. Either you will be bored, either you will be disappointed, either you will be very sad about your performances. So this will be the distress conditions. And in state, you can say that the state of your mind will be of strained and anxious kind of feeling you will be developing. Physiological symptoms of this stress. On our body, the stress creates many kind of things, like increased heart rate, increased breathing rate, increased blood pressure, increased adrenaline release. Adrenaline release is, adrenal is the gland present on the above, just above your kidneys is a pair of gland which secretes the hormone which is responsible for the stress. When the body feels the stress, that hormone is released. Perspiration increases, blood sugar increases. So there are the physiological symptoms which are shown during the stressful condition. Psychological symptoms, here we have the worry or apprehension, irritability in your mind, you will not feel very comfortable, inability to concentrate on your task, difficulty in making decisions in your life, aggression, sometimes aggression is shown while the symptoms of stress, increased rate of speech, you will say loudly or fastly during the stress. So aggression and increased rate of speech is shown in the matches. You have seen that some players show they do not control their aggression while in the playing condition, when they are not happy with the decision of the umpires or the decision of the coaches or the decision of your referees present there. Here we are with the stress response cycle. Through this cycle, we can easily understand about the process of stress, how it flows. So in this, the first column shows you about the environmental demands. The stressors, we usually call them, the physical and the psychological. Stressors are there which creates some demands in your mind, and you want to fulfill that demands, then you flow, then you move forward with the other steps of this stress response cycle. And the next step is the perception of demands. So you will now use your cognition for the perception of your demands. The amount of physical and the psychological threat perceived by those demands. Next is the stress response, that is about the physical and the emotional response you will show. The muscles will be tightened up, they will be in the tensed form. You will feel more anxious in that particular situation. That is your stress response related to the demand. Next is the behavioral consequences. In behavioral consequences, the performance and the outcome will be affected. The ultimate outcome of this stress response cycle will be that only. That will be your behavior that is shown against that particular stress. Let us deeply understand this process, that we have said that environmental demands are the stressors. So let us have an example here. when you are performing a skill in front of a class or the parents, so there will be pressurizing condition in the young athletes to win that particular situation, that race we want to win, that particular competition we want to win, because we are performing in class, front of the class or the parents, so you have to win in any condition. So that is the environmental demand or the stressors that are present in your, in the form of physical or the psychological modes. So next will be your perception of demands. So here you will be one individual can take this demand in a positive manner and another individual can take this demand in a negative manner. For example, when you are performing in the class, one person may enjoy the attention the other classmates are giving to him, and in the same place the other individual may be feel frightened or threatened, like he may not be able to speak very fluently in front of so much of population. So one perceives an imbalance between the demand placed on them or and their ability to meet those needs. So there will be the imbalance between the demand which is placed on the individual, like you have to win, that is the demand, but their ability to meet that particular demand or meet that particular need will not be that much up to that particular level. So there will be imbalance. Your demand is high and the individual's capacities are low. Or on the other hand, the other person, he may be enjoying that particular state, because he will be developing himself enough to meet that particular demand. He will not perceive that condition into a imbalanced condition. That condition becomes automatically positive or fruitful for that person. So perception matters. Perception is in positive direction or in the negative direction. In this process, the next step is the stress response. So after the perception of that demand, there will be the response. The individual will show the state anxiety or arousal, or he may feel very relaxed. He will be performing very well. So that is the stress response. So according to that stress response, the behavioral consequences will be coming. The performance or the outcome will be like the performance might be the performance is increased or the performance will be decreased. That are the performance outcomes. So this will be the actual behavior of the individual under the stressful condition. Now here we are with the causes of stress within the sporting environment. So we have the two main key stresses. You can say the two main key factors which are responsible for the stress in the sporting environment. First one is the importance of the event. How much important that event is for the individual, that athlete is competing. And second one is the level of uncertainty surrounding that event. How much uncertain conditions can arise during that particular event. So these are the two threats which an individual feels during the sporting sporting conditions. So along with these two main key factors, here comes the competition itself is a stressful factor for the athlete. The threat to ego, being judged, who is judging them, that is one of the main stressing factor. Who will be the judges, how many judges will be there, and their ego is hurt when they are not judged very they are not judged properly. So these are the few things the competition creates in the mind of the athletes. Then next is the frustration. Frustration is caused by mistakes. Mistake from the official side, the mistakes from the athlete side, mistake from the coaches. So frustration will be created in the athlete's mind. And the frustration is also occurs when a person goes with an injury during the time of play. And he is not able to perform his best because of that injury. So the frustration also occurs that time. And when the individual is not allowed to play in his own way, when he is forced to play in a particular conditions or in a particular way only that the coach wants. So that time also the athlete faces the frustration levels. Next is the conflict. The conflict in the mind of athlete or the coach is very much key factor in reducing the stress. So a conflict with the opposition may be there. The individual may not be having this good relationship with the competitors. He may fight on the ground, or competition or conflict with the other players other players of his own team, they will be having some conflict issues. They are not very much together to decide a particular things, or conflict with the coaches, in fact with the crowd also, the spectators that are sitting there. Sometimes the athlete feels conflict with them also, there is some verbal issues along with that. So conflict is one of the main factor which gives rise to the stressful conditions. Next is the environment. Environment can be considered as the climate or the pitch or the climate or the surroundings in which a particular match is going to be performed. That plays an important factor. When the environment is not good, the individual will feel stressed, and when the environment is not according to the home environment in which he was playing there, so then also there will be a particular kind of stress in his mind. And in this slide you can see here the effect of stress on sporting performance. I have elaborated with the positive and the negative effects also, which we have already discussed in the previous slides. In terms of the stress perception can be positive or negative, and along with that we have also discussed the types of stress, eustress and the distress, in the positive and negative way. Here let us slightly describe this. Positive effects of players will be like, the players will see the stress as an opportunity to challenge themselves. This will increase their energy and psychological motivation, and sometimes this will increase his or her overall performance also. And when a player or the athlete takes this negative, the sporting performance as a negative, then the athlete will see this demand as a threat. He will feel very fearful and threatened. This will increase worry or anxiety among the players, and this will determine that they will underperform or their performance will be negative. And out of this negative, the outcome of this negative perception will be the performance will be reduced. The performance will be in the negative side. And here we have the how outside influences affect your sporting ability. Just we have talked about the environment perspectives in the previous slide. But rather than these listed causes of the stress, there are some new stressing conditions which may arise because of the listed ones. Like lack of sleep will cause the stress. Eating patterns disrupted will be creating a stress in the physical body. Social media will be creating a stress in the mind of the player related to the performance issues he is having. Major life events, happening during the preparation phase. At that time, the individual is facing the sudden death of the loved ones, or he is facing some kind of negative kind of situations in his life. At that time, he is facing accident or something like that. At that time also, the stress is created in the mind of the players. Traveling and the separation from the family is one of the factors. When the players are moved out from their family and they are kept under the strict supervision of their coaches, at that time also they feel stressed, and the self-criticism they are facing, that also creates the stress inside the mind of the players.